Hi, this is JP from Nota Lights over Arkham. This time we are doing the first play with Starlord Euro Pack that just came out here in Finland. So I am playing with the prebuilt leadership deck, and because I have been playing so much with the Galaxy's Most Wanted expansion villains, I decided to take something else to fight against. So I ended up with Green Goblin Mutagen Formula, because that is one of my favorites from the earlier villains that have come out for this game. So I am playing the Green Goblin Mutagen Formula on standard difficulty. We have already set up everything to begin, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the decks, so let's draw our opening hand. Get Daring Escape times 2, Bad Boy, Element Gun, Target Practice and Pulse Grenade. These we really don't need this early. Target Practice is pretty useless at this point. We have one of the element guns, so we could actually just discard it, because we can search for it with setup ability. Pulse grenades, not that useful. I think I'm keeping Bad Boy and drawing 5. So we find the helmet, another pulse grenade, target practice, aerial supremacy and laser blaster, and with the setup ability will take the element gun. Okay, let's see what we can do. So I am looking at the top card and placing this laser blaster on top of my deck, so we get sliding shot, which is much better to get rid of the goblin troll maybe. So let's place an let's see. So we'll flip. We'll cheapen one card we play by 3. We'll play the element gun. Then we'll play Bad Boy. Actually put the support over here. And we'll use aerial supremacy. Pulse grenade, and target practice for Bad Boy. Then we're keeping the sliding shot at this point, because I could play the helmet. I'll just play the helmet. Set up even more, or we'll spend a resource of any type, so we'll exhaust the element gun to defeat this troll, and I'll just ward for 2. I'll keep this in hand, so we're ready up. Draw back up to 5. I'll put it on this side. So we have Daring Escape, Nova Prime, Power of Leadership, Laser Blaster and the Helmet. So next turn we could play Nova Prime, which is a really strong ally. And for now, we go to the villain phase, we add a threat to the main scheme. Green Goblin attacks, I won't defend, so 2 plus 0, take 2 damage. And we add a threat to the main scheme. We get an encounter card. So we get the Goblin Glider for Green Goblin and the Goblin Knight. So I think we want to defeat the Goblin Knight somehow. It's unfortunately elite, so Nova Prime can't just get rid of it. But we'll have to figure out something else. But that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, so first thing first, we'll take an encounter card. We'll play Nova Prime. Take an encounter card to Daring Escape. Before that, we'll hit this guy for 2. Ready with the Daring Escape. I'll draw a card. And I'll hit this guy for an additional 2. And Nova Prime will defeat it. Oh yeah, we have to pay for the Nova Prime with 2. So we lost... let's just lose the Laser Blaster and our leadership. Last thing I'll do is to play the Star-Lord's Helmet. So while you are in hero form, you'll get +1 hand size for each face down encounter card in front of you to a maximum of 3. Actually, did I take... I think I messed up because I can't... how did I get it to... Oh yeah, the other one was from the Daring Escape. Yeah, my mistake there. I thought I did the once per round ability twice, but it wasn't so. So I played the Star-Lord's Helmet, so now I have +2 hand size. Are we ready up? We get 7 cards. We get Place for Glory, Gutsy Move, another Place for Glory, Power Leadership, Air Supremacy, CITT, and Laser Blaster. We add a threat to the main scheme. Green Goblin attacks. I'm just taking it with Star-Lord. So 3 plus 1, 4 damage. And I'm just discarding Bad Boy at this point. So when you would take any amount of damage from the villain attack, discard this card, prevent all of that damage, change to Alter Ego and Form and cards. So we draw 2 more cards, which is another Laser Blaster and Sliding Shot. Okay. Then we get an encounter card. So, regenerate healing. This guy gains surge because no damage was healed. He gets intimidation. Choose to either spend 2 resources of any time to give him a boost card. Yeah, let's give the boost card. So, I think I'll place the boost card here so I don't mess up with the encounter cards I draw with the Star-Lord's ability. I see you. Okay, Green Goblin attacks you if you are in Alter Ego form. Do not give the villain a boost card for this activation. So this still applies, so 3 plus 2 is 5. So we take 5 damage and 1 threat is added. And we get a Goblin Troll. Okay, well, that was the villain phase, and let's go to the next hero phase. I think the first thing we do is heal for 3 damage. Then I will look at the top card, take it into hand, and put one of the laser blasters down. Then... we're just flipping. Not feeling the Blaze of Glories at this point. So I'll just... How do I want to do this? think Gutsy move could be a good. So first thing is that. Yeah, I'm just using Nova to get rid of this troll. Or no, that's wasteful. I'll use the element gun, discard one of the Blaze of Glories to deal 3 damage to an enemy. And then I'll play the Laser Blaster on Nova. I'll use the other Blaze of Glory. Nova hits for 4 damage here. I think we want to get rid of the glider. So I'll spend 2 energy resources. I'll use the Pulse Grenade and the Power of Leaders for that to remove the Goblin Glider. Then I'm paying reducing the sliding shot cost down to 0 with Starlord's ability. So I deal 5 damage plus 2 additional for each space diamond counter card. So 7. And then I'll play the Gutsy move. I'll use CIT and Air Supremacy. And I'll remove 2 threat from a scheme and then remove 2 additional threat from that scheme. So I'll remove all of this. And that is our turn. Be ready up. So back up to. I have the helmet, so back up to 6. We get Laser Blaster, Leader of the Guardians, Yondu, Adam Warlock, Sliding Shot, and Air Supremacy. We add a threat to the main scheme. Green Goblin attacks, and Nova will defend for this attack. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So Nova Prime is defeated. We get an encounter card. First one is overrun. Not that bad. Then we get Hysteria. So I think we want to also get rid of the Hysteria. But that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next zero phase. We definitely want to play both of these allies to set up. So I'll play Yondu by taking an encounter card and using the Air Supremacy. Then I'll play Adam Warlock, use the rest of these cards. And then I will get rid of this by thwarting. So, when defeated in player order, each player must discard 2 cards from the encounter deck and put each goblin discarded this way into play. Shadow of the Past and Pumpkin Bombs. So, nothing bad. Oh yeah, we forgot about the Hysteria. So, well, we need to suffer 1 turn of Hysteria. Then we'll thwart with Adam Warlock. We reveal the top card here, and was it reveal or discard? Discard. Oh no, it's from hand. So just shuffle this. New cards. So after Adam Warlock attacks, fourth discard 1 card. But I think I'm saving Adam Warlock actually. I'll save it for next turn. But Yondu attacks for 1. And doesn't take the attack of or consequential damage. And that is the hero phase. Go to the villain phase, and we have one card, so we have a ancestral fix. Get ready, better a heal, get ready, nowhere, target practice, and Cosmo. We are a threat to the main scheme. Green Goblin attacks, I will defend with Star-Lord. Can I really afford that? Green Goblin gets an additional boost card, so it might be fatal. Well, let's risk it. I'll just take it with Star-Lord. I'll defend. Lower it by one. So 2 plus 3 is 5, minus 1 is 4, so we're still alive. And we add a threat to the main scheme. Then we get encounter cards. First one is Banishment. I'll discard the elemental gun. And Assault, so unfortunately Adam Warlock has to defend for this one. Let's do it with Yondu. So, Green Goblin hits for 2, plus heal 2 damage and 1. So, Yondu is defeated. Heal 2 damage. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So, this turn. I don't think better ABL is that necessary at this point. Well, we could hit it with it a bunch of times. I think I'm taking that risk, so I'll cheapen it by 3. I'll use target practice and nowhere to pay for better ABL. And we have. Okay, so mental means heal 3, deal 3 damage to an enemy, so this will be a really hard-hitting turn. So, but we'll definitely go to Alter Ego. Okay. So, Battery Bill will hit for 3 damage. Then we'll ready. We'll hit for 3 damage. Green Goblin goes to Alter Ego. Into phase 2. Deal 2 encounter cards for each player. And then I think I will. Yeah, let's put health here. So we'll hit for another 3. So we hit, ready, hit, get ready, hit, so another 3 damage here, and we'll thwart for 1, and we'll discard 1 card at random, it deals 3 damage, and then we'll go to Alter Ego. And that is it, we'll ready up. Let's see if we can survive the villain phase. I think we could win the game if we just survive this one turn. So So this only is in hero form, so we don't get the extra cards, unfortunately. So we have Jet Boots, Base of Glory, Gutsy Move, Air Supremacy, Pulse Grenade, and Cosmo. So now that I'm thinking of it, I really should have had the wait with better ability until we have the Blaze of Glory in hand to do that, but always can't wait for all of the combos. So we add a threat to the main team. Green Goblin schemes for 2 plus 2 boost cards. 0, so only 2. We didn't even advance, which is great, but we put the Goblin Troll into play and Goblin Nation into play. That is still okay. Then we get a ton of encounter cards. Okay, let's see if we can survive this. First one is Goblin Glider. That's okay. Goblin Soldier, that is okay. A Troll. Goblin Reinforcements. When revealed, place one additional threat here for each Goblin minion in place of 3, so it's actually 5. So we really need to rush down. We need to kill the... Well, we have one aerial, we play the boost 2 aerial, so we can just kill these off with the aerial supremacy, then we just need to hit for a ton. And advance, so we actually advance, so... Not that big of a deal. Well, it is not nice. So... Start this with 4 of 11, and now this X is 4 because we have 4 Goblin enemies in play. Well, that was the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, well, I think we just might be able to finish this turn, so let's just quickly check. So. Yeah, we could play the Air Supremacy, but we need to play the boots. We play the boots, so we have 2 aerials, so we play the Air Supremacy to get rid of the Trolls. Then we'll play the Blaze Glory. And... We're unfortunately one resource short from that plan, so instead I will see what we can do. So could deal 3 with this, so let's count again. Okay, so we just need to kill 1, then Adam Warlock can defeat one of the Trolls, then trigger that, so we need to have a mental resource on top of the deck, so I'll switch Cosmo onto the top of my deck, so we get an aerial supremacy. I think this might work now, so we'll flip. We'll take an extra encounter card to play down the boots. Now we have... No, we don't need the boots. Don't need the boots. We'll play Air Supremacy to defeat 1 Troll. We'll take an extra 2. Okay, let's... this is so hard math. So, back up. And, so, we could play 1. Taking counter card, defeat this guy, we need 2 for that, and no, okay, so we'll play Blaze of Glory. Just put it over here so I remember. So everything has plus 2 attack and plus 2 dwarf that is a guardian, and these are all guardian. So Adam Warlock will hit the Goblin Troll. Then we'll flip this card. It's a 3 damage one, so we'll place 3 damage here. Better I Bill hits for 5, gets defeated. And Starlord finishes the game off by hitting for 4 damage here. Phew. Well, that was a tight finish there, so. Great, we did it. So, Starlord with the prebuilt deck against the Green Goblin on standard difficulty. Green Goblin can be quite tough when you get a ton of encounter cards, and we were nearly dead there, but we managed to pull out the win on the last turn, and we would have died probably on the next turn. So, I'm really interested in seeing how Starlord will function in other builds. Leadership is for some reason not one of my favorite builds. I don't know why. It just is like that. I prefer Justice and Protection the most, but leadership just doesn't feel like that interesting. It's usually just ally spam, and that's not that interesting. But then again, we are getting pretty interesting new cards for all of the aspects with this Guardian cycle. So we're really looking forward to what we get in Drax and later in Venom hero packs. But thanks for watching this first play with Starlord pre-built deck against Green Goblin Mutagen Formula on standard difficulty. And as always, until next time.